Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing well. I hope you guys are staying safe. In today's video, I'm talking about career lessons that I learned in 2021. Welcome. If you're new here, my name is Happy. I make videos on personal finance, investing, budgeting, saving, sometimes a motherhood, careers, taking the CFA program. And if that is the kind of content that interests you, please consider subscribing in the subscribe button right here. The first career lesson that I learned this year is always put your hand up. I remember sometime this year I attended an event where there were a lot of senior people, some executives, and they are advising junior people. And one of the keynote speakers said that always put your hand up. Sometimes you don't know. Maybe someone is asking who can assist me in this, and you don't know, and you're scared. If you don't raise your hand up, you'll never know. So that keynote speaker was just advising the juniors that always put your hand up, you will learn on the job. So even if sometimes maybe you're working on an assignment but that's not really what you really like, or you think that maybe that industry that the assignment is about is not something you're really interested in, just put your hand up, you never know. Another leader was just saying that right now I am in this career option, but in the beginning I was in a completely different field, and it was just because I kept raising my hand up. Some assignments were coming in, I was like, okay, let me try this, and you try them and you're like, okay, this interests me, and then you take up some more assignments, you take some courses. In the end, what really helped them in their career was just they were willing to take on new tasks, they are willing to raise their hand, they're just willing to do anything to get the job done. So an important career lesson that I learned this year is just put your hand up, you never know what it will lead to. My second career lesson that I learned this year is being known for something. I watched a video on Kit Career's YouTube channel. I don't remember the exact video, but I'll put a link to her channel here. Where she was talking about the analogy of the bus. She was with her mom, and then so they're giving this is it a story where like in the olden days there was if you're traveling, you'll be traveling in a big bus, so most times you find that all the seats are full and there are people who are standing at the center holding that metal thing that runs at the center. So as you're driving, the driver knows this, so as he's driving, there's a time that maybe there'll be a sharp corner, so the driver makes a really sharp corner, and when he makes this sharp corner, those people who are seated will move because you're leaning on one side, and then some space will appear on that seat. So at this point, you as a passenger who's standing holding that metal thing, you have to really be quick and look, okay, fine, there's no space here, and then sit. So the driver will continue going, and then he'll make another turn, and then now the people who are sitting on this other side will now move, and space will form. If you are still standing, you just be quick so that you can sit. And in this story, they're saying that like in life, maybe in your job or whatever it is, sometimes maybe you are the newest person there. Just look for maybe an event, something will happen that there's going to be space that will form. In the beginning, everyone is comfortable, everyone is not sharing their space, but something will happen and then space will form. Just be quick to notice that there's space here that is formed and sit on it. So that really taught me. Like this year, I joined from a whole different country, and I could just decide to be okay, fine, I'm still the Tanzanian, I'm the new person here, and everyone is doing their business and everyone is comfortable, and sometimes you might be the new person for so long, but events happen, so you really need to think of ways in which when space appears, you take your space so that you are known that, okay, fine, this person does this in this organization. And that can really help you in your career. In the same way, like maybe in family or at work, it's really nice to be known for something. Maybe if people are planning a party, they know that, okay, fine, they have to contact this one, this person, because maybe she knows cake vendors, or they contact this person because she knows this. Yeah, you just have to look for events, look for something that you are known. You are known for that particular thing, and it can really help. You don't need the newbie in an organization for so long. So even if you're joining an organization, look for things that you can just be known for. Yes, in an organizational setting, yes, you're doing our jobs, but there are also other things. Maybe you can be the person who is known for organizing social events. You can be known as the person who, maybe if they need someone to take pictures, you are going to be the person who takes pictures, or just anything. It's really good for your career. Another career lesson that I learned this year is always apply for jobs, even when you're not looking. Even when you have no plan of moving from your organization, it's just nice to know what is out there, what are people of your skills being paid out there. Are you being underpaid? Are you being overpaid? It's just good to know that. I think I saw this on an Instagram, maybe post of one of the people I follow. Just know what is out there. Like, I moved from Tanzania to Kenya, and here the job market is so different. There are so many career options for someone with my qualifications. So just be coming here, it's just good to know, okay, fine, in Tanzania this is the salary scale, but in Kenya these are the various options for me, just in case a day that happens that I'm looking for a job, I know, okay, fine, I could go to this industry, and these are the kinds of salaries I'll be looking at. So it's just important, just apply for jobs, know what's out there. You don't want to find yourself in a situation where maybe you get frustrated in a job, and that is when you start looking for it, because job search can take months, can take weeks, can take a year or so. It's good to know what's out there even when you're not looking, so that once you start looking, you already know, okay, fine, maybe this is where I need to narrow down my search. These are the kind of industries I'm interested in. These are the kind of salaries I should be looking at. Another career lesson that I learned, and this is something I've always known, but it is even more evident this year, dress for the occasion. Now, we work so much at home. Even when you go to the office, people are not as official as used to, because you find that maybe you don't even have a client meeting. But you should always dress for the occasion. You never know that one day you've gone to the office, maybe that is when the partner will come, that's when the CEO will come, and you don't want to be just shabbily dressed. Dress for the occasion, because one day those senior guys will have a meeting and they'll think, okay, fine, let's call this person. Yes, that person is a junior, but we know that she'll look the part, she'll look respectable, she'll look official. So as much as we now work from home, the few days maybe you have something to go and do in the office, and it's really easy to say, okay, fine, there's no one in the office. Really, like right now I could go to the office and I will not meet anyone, but you never know who might be in the office that day. So just dress for the occasion. If you're even going for maybe an office cocktail or whatever, make sure you're dressed, because you impression matters, and you never know what could happen in the future just because these senior people were seeing you dressed like the way you're dressed. Another career lesson that I learned, and this was even more evident this year, is invest in yourself. Brush up your skills. What are the skills that you're struggling with that you could improve? Take up an extra course. It all helps. It all helps in the end. Now you're working from home, you might, just because you're not spending some time sitting in traffic, you could use that time to spend an hour or two daily to take up a course that you're really interested in. It can help you so that you can get maybe assigned a project that you're interested in. I remember in the beginning of the year, okay, not even in the beginning of the year, I always knew that I want to improve my financial modeling skills, and for some reason I was never taking up courses, but this year I got serious. I took up a financial modeling course, and some of my managers knew that. So when a project came, they're like, oh, happy, can you assist me with this? And it was just good, because I was given project because people know, okay, fine, she's taking up a course. So think of ways in which you can improve your skills. Take up an extra class, just do something, because the world is changing. There are so many things to learn out there, and you don't want to just be sitting with your degree that you took years ago. And there are so many courses out here that you could take. And a final career lesson that I learned this year is to plan. Plan your week, plan your weekend. I think from mid this year I started being really intentional about planning. Because sometimes you find that you have so much to do. I have my 9-to-5 job. I need to take care of my house. I need to take care of my son. So there will just be too many things that are all happening, and I need to have set time for them. So it's really helped me. Even sometimes, like, I would plan. Usually I plan on Sundays for the whole week, and then maybe on Thursday or Friday I will sit down and kind of keep in, how do I want to spend my time over the weekend? So it just helps me. That sometimes you go out and then you lose track of time. You come and sleep in the morning, and then now all your activities for the weekend are all messed up. So it just helps to plan so that you can accomplish what you really want to accomplish. So that's all, guys. Those are the career lessons that I learned this year. Let me know in the comment section down below what career lessons you learned this year, so that we may all learn from each other. If you like this video, you might also like my other video here where I share career lessons that I learned in my 20s. If you like this video, please don't forget to click the like button and to subscribe right here if you want to subscribe. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.